Welcome to the Campus Solutions 9.2 PUM 22 video feature overview. Before I get started, please read the following Safe Harbor Statement. Thank you. Today's agenda is as follows: a PUM 22 overview, a PeopleTools 85902 update, PUM 22 and recent fluid updates, program enrollment, activity management updates, and financial aid updates. Let's go ahead and get started with a PUM 22 overview. . 207 bug fixes are included in PUM 22, of which 19 are accessibility bugs. PUM 22 is delivered on PeopleTools 85902. Let's take a look at a PeopleTools 85902 update. The new tools delivery has delivered a new homepage. Notice on the left side of the homepage are two icons. The first is recently visited. The second is favorites. At the top left corner of the new homepage is the homepage dropdown selector. The user will be presented with the homepages they have security access to. On the right side, if the user does not want to use the dropdown, they can quickly and easily switch between homepages. In the top center is called search and menu. This feature enables the user, in this case a student, to type in the word grades. The student would be presented with the page or pages that they have security access to. By clicking on the search result, they'll be taken directly to that page. In this staff example, the staff member has typed in maintain schedule of classes. The search result is easily clickable and it will take that staff user directly to that page. On the right side of the new homepage is the nav bar. Notice that the icons have changed. This is recently visited, favorites, and the menu. The menu in 85902 is delivered alphabetical. If a user would prefer to return to the standard or previous version of the menu, they select standard, hit save, and they're presented with the previous menu structure. In addition to those changes, PeopleTools 85902 has introduced the return of breadcrumbs. Now I can quickly and easily navigate to the previous menus that I have visited along the way to my final destination. In addition to those features, Tools 85902 has delivered a notification panel. This notification panel is on the homepage. But if the user does not want to use that notification panel, they can quickly and easily personalize their homepage, slide that show notifications panel selector to no, and hit save. The notifications panel will no longer show on their homepage. In addition to the large form factor, the small form factor has made some changes as well. Notice the tile structure, it's a stacked tile structure. In 85902, the recently visited and favorites icons are at the bottom of that page, and the nav bar is on the right-hand side. That concludes our brief overview of 85902. Now let's take a look at PUM 22 and recent fluid updates. We've delivered two tile configuration and one performance update in PUM 22, so let's take a look. The first is the academic advisement or the academic progress tile. Remember that breadcrumbs are here, so we know where we are. It's in a new folder called fluid configuration, AA tile configuration. So let's take a look. The campus has the choice to suppress the calculation of the academic progress report and the fluid academic progress chart in the academic progress tile by selecting that checkbox. You can place a message, in this case, click here to see your academic progress, select a start date and an end date, and go ahead and save that. And that's what shows to the student when they enter the homepage or refresh their homepage. The second item on that menu is the student finance or the financial account tile configuration. Similar to the academic progress tile, if I select that checkbox, I can disable the tuition calculation on that financial account tile. So each time the student enters that page or refreshes, no longer will tuition calc run in the background. You can place a display message, in this case, click here for payment, select a start on and end time, and go ahead and save. And notice now we have two tiles, one, the financial account, and the second, academic progress with our custom messages. In addition to those features that we've delivered in PUM 22, is the ability to configure the student records activity guide, specifically the enrollment activity guide. Let's take a look. This is the setup page for that configuration. Notice all the checkboxes are on. But let's take a look at to see what it looks like before I check all those checkboxes, just to refresh your memory. This is the delivered student records enrollment activity guide. Notice there are four steps present here, but there's actually a fifth step, and we'll see that in a moment. So the delivered is review class section, selection, review class preferences, add or enroll to cart, review and submit. And once I hit submit, there's actually a fifth step, which is a confirmation message that says, are you sure you want to submit? Once I click yes, then I'm enrolled or my class goes to the shopping cart. Let's take a look at the configuration options that are available in PUM 22 for the enrollment activity guide. Notice I've selected all the checkboxes. So let's take a look to see what that looks like. Now we're presented with two steps instead of five. Review class preferences now includes items such as, do you wish to enroll or add your class to the shopping cart? Would you like to add this class to the wait list? A permission number. If there was a requirement designation or a student grade option, those would be presented on this page as well. Once I accept that and move to the second or final step, I can review my selection, I can hit submit, and I'm immediately enrolled into the class without a confirmation message, or my class is added to the shopping cart. Let's move on to some of the more recent fluid updates that we've delivered in the previous PUMs. The first is fluid enrollment appointments. Notice on the homepage, the manage classes tile, there's a message here. It says two active appointments. Those two active appointments really correspond to the menu that the student has access to once they click on that tile. Notice the enrollment appointments menu item. There's a two in a badge that corresponds with those active appointments, okay? Those two appointments are, in this case, is a shopping cart appointment as well as an enrollment appointment. The next recent fluid update is the fluid weekly schedule calendar. Again, I'll be navigating from the manage classes tile directly to view my classes in fluid. Notice the by date tab is active, and we've added a new calendar view to that tab. Also on that particular page is the ability for the student to filter out the display options that they would like to see by selecting or deselecting the days of the week they would like to have in their view. In addition to that feature, each cell has a hyperlink that will enable the student to look at the details for that class, including meeting information, enrollment, class details, and class availability. In addition to the features I've talked about, is the ability for the student to print this page. So once the student clicks on the printable page, they'll be taken to a view where they can actually print that page, which corresponds to the page that they just left. The next feature that we've delivered for Fluid is Fluid Enrollment Verifications. Fluid Enrollment Verifications are located on the Academic Records tile. The last item in that menu is Enrollment Verification. The student has two options upon entering this page. The first option is to allow to print from my browser. The second option is for the institution to mail that request. All the corresponding information then is available to the student to identify where they'd like that to be mailed. We've also provided the ability to enter a custom instruction message to the students. Notice the information icon next to new request. The text catalog is where you would enter this instruction to the student, save it, and that message would be presented each time the student clicks on that that blue eye. Once the student submits the request to print in a browser, it'll quickly and easily pop up a PDF for the student to go ahead and print and be able to use that enrollment verification for whatever purpose they would like. In addition to that, all of their previous requests will be available on the second tab, which is View Request Status. If the request is a mail-in request, that request status will update when that mail has been completed. Let's move on to the Program Enrollment Activity Management Updates. Program Enrollment has delivered a new APT, or the Academic Progress Tracker, Transfer Batch Sync process. The APT sync process is an enhancement to the program enrollment functionality that allows an administrator to synchronize enrollment and transfer credit transactions to the student's APT. In addition, the details of the enrollment and transfer credit are carried over to that APT when the term and course matches the AIR and the APT course item, or when a valid course equivalency has been identified. Drop courses and unposted transfer credits are also synchronized to the APT. A new APT sync folder has been added under program enrollment. Let's take a look. Notice again, my breadcrumbs at the top will show you exactly how I got to this new APT sync folder. It's under records and enrollment, program enrollment, APT sync. In addition to that, we've delivered a new run control page for this APT transfer batch sync process. Let's move on to financial aid updates. The first we'll talk about are profile updates for 2022-2023. Campus Solutions is providing our annual update for College Board profile users for award year 2022-2023. Fields on the maintain application for 22-23 have been updated in accordance to layout changes as indicated by the College Board. We have updated the profile load process to accommodate the ability to load profile correction transactions from the College Board. When loading profile XML files for award year 2022-23, you will see a new setting on the run control labeled as Load Updated Profiles. You will have control if this is set to yes or no. Selecting yes will allow new profile transactions received for a student to overwrite any profile data that had been previously loaded to application tables. You can elect to have separate business rules for loading updated profiles for custodial parent profiles versus non-custodial parent profiles. On the maintain application page for 22-23, we've added new sections that display transaction information related to that profile record loaded, including the transaction number and if that transaction is considered a correction by the College Board. These sections are on the student tab for the custodial parent profile and on the non-custodial data tab for the non-custodial parent profile. The correction reason section added to our maintain applications pages will provide you with user-defined responses as to what was updated on the profile correction transaction. If the load updated profile option is set to no on the profile load run control, any updated profile transaction attempted to be loaded will be sent to suspense management. You can load updated profile transactions from suspense management if you choose. Campus Solutions will track the transaction number of the profile being loaded for each student. If you attempt to load a profile transaction that is out of sequence, that transaction will be sent to suspense management. New fields indicating transaction number and correction status have been added to the suspense management and load summary pages to provide users with additional information on process transactions. Here's some examples. As per the electronic announcement DL-2102, provided by a federal student aid, the requirement for the completion of the annual student loan acknowledgement prior to disbursement of federal student loans will not go into effect for 2021-22 award year. In response to this update, as part of the PUM 22 release, the authorization and disbursement COBOLs have been updated to no longer check for the completion of the informed borrower fields for the 21-22 award year. No other updates have been made to the delivered 2021-2022 COD updates that were released as part of PUM 21. This concludes the PUM 22 video feature overview. Thank you.